Hey guys, it's Mike. I review nootropics and I talk personal development. And during this video, you're going to learn about the racetams. Just in terms of effectiveness, I would rank racetam 6 out of 10, oxiracetam 8 out of 10, aniracetam 7 out of 10, pramiracetam as well 7 out of 10, and phenylparacetam 9 out of 10. Stay tuned to the end of the video because I'm going to touch on phenylparacetam and NuPEP, which are kind of like two secret racetams, you could say, and they should be used in a very different way than the rest of the racetams. So what so is, I was initially taking paracetam to start with, and that is the, you can say, most known racetam. It was back founded, I think, in the 1960s, and then since then, 20 derivatives of paracetam have been made since. And what it's essentially used for is a general cognition, you can say memory, work ethic, a little bit of energy, and that feeling of waking up with a little bit more ambition. But the challenge is with these racetams, except for phenylparacetam, is they take a little bit of time to work. So with paracetam, the ideal way in which one would take it would be something like 2 grams a day across 2 servings. So maybe 1 gram in the beginning of the day and 1 gram at night. And what it's responsible for is that, but it's not stimulating. I think that's where a lot of people go wrong with paracetam, is they're expecting some sort of immediate effect of feeling energetic like you would with caffeine. No, this is something that's subtle. I found over the years that it's especially noticeable if you're a student. So for students, I think paracetam is a great nootropic. But even if you're somebody like an entrepreneur, because overall, cerebrally, you'll find that it's far more easier to be a little bit more sophisticated to solve some of those problems that you typically wouldn't be able to. But what makes it unique to other nootropics is that paracetam goes very well with other nootropic stacks. Like, there's other nootropics which are gonna appeal to you, and if you were to ask the question of, can I add paracetam to that nootropic stack? Generally, the answer is yes, because this isn't the strongest nootropic, but it also doesn't have very strong side effects, which is a good plus. So paracetam, I like it a lot. And now let's talk about oxiracetam. This is where things get a little bit interesting, because this is a lot more potent than paracetam is. From the moment you take oxiracetam, you feel mentally stimulated. Your priorities come top of mind, you're very clear-minded, and you have that tunnel vision to focus on something and defocus on everything else. So I like it, it's effective, you'll notice it working, but you do need to dose it very differently. You with oxiracetam, the way in which I'm typically taking it is 800 milligrams 2 to 3 times per day. From my experience, just reading through comments from all of you great subscribers on this channel, it's such that oxiracetam seems to work immediately for like 50% of people, and then the other 50% of people seem to notice oxiracetam working when it's like somewhat saturated in your system after a couple of weeks or so. But I'm one of the people that oxiracetam definitely does work immediately upon ingestion, and I like it a lot, but this is something which you wouldn't use as frequently as paracetam, as there is a little bit of a buildup with respect to your tolerance. So I've talked about that more in depth in this video here, but let's move on and talk about aniracetam. So aniracetam is like the social racetam, you can say. It has benefits across anxiety, has benefits across being more intentional about connecting with people, wanting to go and talk to people in the first place and get a little bit out of your comfort zone, maybe have that courage that you typically wouldn't have to go ahead and approach someone. So it's ideal for people, especially in sales. Has a little bit of a benefit across memory, but it's not that much of a game changer that you would need it necessarily for studying. If you're like me and you consider yourself to be like a massive introvert and you know you should make like a little bit more effort to mix and mingle and maybe expand your network, that's where aniracetam can really be a game changer. So the way in which I would be using it would be 500 milligrams across 2 to 3 times per day. Again, this is similar to paracetam. I would recommend that before you do give it a fair evaluation, give it a couple of weeks. You should notice something. For me, what that looked like was after a few months when I took it out of my stack, I could definitely tell that my anxiety was up a little bit and I was just more likely to avoid conversations versus approach them and be immersed into them. All right, now, racetam number 4 is pramiracetam. Come to think of this like the discipline nootropic, it has a very unique effect in that you're able to do like tedious, repetitive work again and again and again, and it has this effect of like completely numbing down your emotions in a very good way, although it can blunt creativity. Just like take those 1 or 2 most highest paying activities and you know that you should be spending all day just doing those, that's where pramiracetam is really, really strong. Willpower, discipline, execution. It's a very beneficial nootropic because I haven't found anything that straight up just helps my willpower as much as pramiracetam. Like for me, what that looked like was making sales calls. I mean, I could go like 8 to 10 hours through if I'm taking a lot of pramiracetam, which I typically wouldn't be able to. With this nootropic, it's very potent. I would say 300 milligrams 2 to 3 times a day. Little neat tweak though, make sure you get it in the capsule form because this one tastes absolutely awful. Although this expensive is horribly pricey compared to the other ones, it still is beneficial in that it's like not stimulating. And you want to be mindful of stimulants because they have like what comes up, what comes down effect, they have a crash. Pramirastam, no, but you get this like boost of memory. Seems to work very, very well, I find, with aniracetam because the aniracetam seems to like offset whatever pramirastam does in reducing your emotion and just makes you still feel like yourself, yet having that really strong work ethic. These four racetams that we've discussed, these are nootropics that generally you can take every single day. They're not like these scary nootropics that work the whole day. They're crazy strong like modafinil or phenylparacetam. No, these are things which you can typically even use together. Like I find really good experiences from using all these four nootropics together. And if you're getting value out of this video, be sure to support the channel by clicking subscribe and give it a like. So phenylparacetam, it's completely different than the rest of the racetams, but it's important to note it is a derivative of paracetam. So with phenylparacetam, come to think of this as like one of those nootropics you can take once in the beginning of the day and get the benefit throughout the whole day. It's a stimulant. You're not going to notice anything the following day, really, or maybe a come down. So it's something which is going to keep you alert, energized. You're getting cognition, you're getting improved memory, you're getting alertness, yet at the same time it seems to not be like caffeine in that you're a little bit calmer, you don't feel uneasy, you don't have anxiety. Actually with phenylparacetam, this is like the master networking pill because you're able to be on your feet, you're able to interact with people, you have so much energy and resilience to like go through task, not feel any sort of general fatigue or needing to have a break. With phenylparacetam, like we're talking about something that is so potent, you only need 100 milligrams once, like right in the morning. That's how I'm taking it. Some users take 150 to 200, maybe even 300. For me, that's far too much because with phenylparacetam, if you take too much and you take it for too long, too many consecutive days, you will feel some sort of withdrawal, some sort of calm down effect. So the way in which I'm using it is only maybe 2 to 3 times per week at max. I would really recommend you avoid taking it 2 days consecutively as you'll just kind of forget who you are. You have so much energy, but it's a really good nootropic and has the benefits across cognition. Even when you're sleep deprived, you typically need some sort of pick me up. And that's where I find phenylparacetam especially useful. Phenylparacetam, I could talk about the benefits for like maybe 5 minutes, so I will do that in this video over here in order to keep this somewhat brief. But I also want to close this video by mentioning that if you're not noticing anything from the racetams, likely it's that you are not taking enough choline. So I would recommend that you look into taking some sort of choline supplement, my favorites being CDP choline or alpha GPC, because that's a practical way in which most people take these racetams. It's such that they're using, for example, paracetam and choline 2 to 3 times per day. And then same thing with the rest of the nootropics. Hope this video was helpful, guys, but I do want to mention that Nupept is also a very, very powerful nootropic that is somewhat like paracetam and is also very strong for improving your work ethic. So I'm going to finish this video by including an insertion of a video I've made on Nupept here. Be sure to let me know what's your favorite racetam. I want to see that in the comment box. Click subscribe, click like, and by the time this video is out, I'm probably close to hitting 10,000 subscribers. So hey, I really appreciate all of you more so than you know, and I'll look forward to seeing you all next time. Take care, guys. Talked about using alpha GPC as a good choline source. As well with that, I'd recommend that you check out the adaptogen, which I've made a lot of videos about. So what adaptogens do is they help you to build your stress resilience, which means you're able to tolerate more stress in general to the point that stress almost excites you. You'll have a better work ethic. You'll want to get things done and you want to be really